Hello dear students and my dear friends, assalamu alaikum. Welcome back to Top Lesson for you. Dear students, as you know, we are recording in AshiqullahTopTop lectures, but upon the request of my some students and my friends, they call that dear sir, please record about the mitosis and meiosis. Those are the cell divisions, right, which occur inside our body and the body of other organisms. But we are, as we are discussing human anatomy, so we are human doctors. So we should know that how mitosis and meiosis occur inside our body, right? So now in this lecture, I'm discussing about mitosis or cell division. So before going to mitosis, we should know that what happens before the cell division. What happens before cell division? So let me first of all clear our concept that what happens before cell division, then we will move towards mitosis there and we will see what happens during mitosis, right friends? So first of all, we should know that there is a cycle which is going inside our body in the cells, right? That is called cell cycle. So first of all, we should have a clear concept of the cell cycle, that what is cell cycle and what are the events which are occurring in the cell cycle. Then we will move towards the cell division, that is mitosis or meiosis, right friends? So first of all, let me assure you that we should know about cell cycle. Clear friends? So let us define first of all cell cycle. Then we will move towards the events which occur inside the cell during cell cycle and what happens there. Look, dear friends, whenever a cell is going to divide, for example, this is a cell and this cell is going to divide, right? So during division of this cell is going through a series of events, right? This cell goes through a series of events and eventually this cell divides into two daughter cells, right? Look carefully, we have brought one cell into different series of events and made that cell two and divided that cell, right? So what is cell cycle? Cell cycle is a series of events that is occurring inside a cell when it is going to be divided from one cell to two cells. Clear friends? Let us write it. A series of events which occur inside a cell when it is going to divide from one cell to two cells. Clear friends? Let us know it in another way. Look carefully, dear friends. Here is a cell, right? And this cell wants to make division. This cell wants to make two other cells. Clear? Two same cells. Clear friends? Now what will happen? Here will be some steps during which this cell will make different products. And this cell will move through a series of events and eventually after these series of events, this cell will divide into two cells. Clear friends? So we say that, look carefully, we say that during cell cycle, what is cell cycle? What is cell cycle? Cell cycle is a series of events that are occurring inside a cell when it is going to divide from one cell to two cells, right? So these are some special series of events, some steps which are occurring in this cell, and after those events, this cell has divided into two cells. Clear, friends? So what are those events? We write them as there will be G1 phase or gap 1, there will be S phase, right, and there will be G2 phase, and in the end there will be mitosis or mitotic phase. Mitotic, clear, friends? So let's see once again to have a clear concept of what is cell cycle. Clear, friends? So the cell cycle includes those events which are occurring inside the cell when a cell is going to be divided from one cell to two cells. Clear, friends? So you know that the cell cycle consists of these four steps, right? These four events. When these four events completes, the cell divides. Clear? So look carefully. These first three events which are occurring, we call these three events as interphase. Interphase, right? And this last event which occurs, which needs to be occur, which is very important, and this phase is called the mitotic phase. Mitotic phase or division phase, or we call it division phase. Division phase. I hope you are clear about it, right? So after the interphase and after the mitotic phase or division phase, the cell will divide into two cells, and it is occurring inside our body from the time the sperm and ovum meets up to the death, right? Up to the last events of our life, this process is occurring inside our body. I know there are some cells which stop division, and there are some cells which are called the stable cells, and there are some cells which are always dividing cells, so the labile cells are there. We will talk about them in a while, right? So I hope you are understanding about this, what I have said right now. Now let us see what happens during interphase. Dear friends, so in this lecture I'm going to discuss about interphase, that what happens during interphase so that the cell should be ready for mitosis or the division phase. Clear, friends? So let us see here. Dear friends, let us discuss about interphase first of all. Clear, friends? This interphase is also known as preparatory phase. Preparatory phase. Why? Because in previous times this phase was called as the resting phase. In this phase the cell is resting, but now we know that here in this phase the cell is not resting. The cell is preparing itself for the next division. So as to prepare itself for the next cell division, what should this cell do? Either it should rest, it should be in rest condition. No, it should prepare itself for the next cell division. It should prepare itself for the next cell division. Clear, friends? So we say that this interphase is called the preparatory phase. Now let us see what happens during interphase. As you know that this interphase consists of these three phases, the G1 phase, the S phase, and the G2 phase. Let us see here, friends. Let me draw the diagram here. For example, my dear friends, here is a cell, right? And this cell wants to do division. This cell has not yet prepared itself for division. This cell wants to prepare itself for division. Clear, friends? So what will happen? This cell will enter in a cyclic process. The cell will enter in a cyclic process. So look carefully. When this cell wants to start division, wants to prepare itself for cell division, this cell must enter to G1 phase. Right? G1 phase. Now look carefully. When G1 completes, what happens then? the cell a little bit grows in size, right? You can see here the cell is little smaller, but here the cell is little larger. So the cell has increased its size. We will discuss these events in detail in a while, but we are just making a clear concept that what will happen during interphase. Clear? So look carefully. Here the nucleus size also grows. Clear? So G1 phase or gap 1 phase, right, or growth phase. Here the growth phase completes. So you can see the cell has increased its size. Then what will happen after the G1 phase? The cell will enter into another phase, right? The cell will enter into another phase, and that phase is called the S phase. That is called S phase. So during S phase, what happens? Look carefully, friends. Here is our S phase. So during S phase, when the cell enters to S phase, what happens that the DNA which was present in the cell previously, right, this was the DNA, I have uncoiled it. This DNA makes a copy of itself. Clear? Here is the DNA of the cell. And here we should also show the DNA. Clear? So this is the DNA, single DNA. Here look, single DNA, but you can see here DNA has been doubled. DNA has been synthesized. That's why we call this phase as synthesis phase. So this phase is also known as synthesis phase. Clear? So what has been synthesized here? Here, the DNA which was present here during S phase, the DNA has been doubled. DNA has been copied. DNA has been replicated. So that's why we call this synthesis or S phase also replicative phase. Replicative phase. Done. So during S phase, what happens? Replication of DNA occurs. It means DNA which is present here, it is 2N, 2 capital N. But here 2N plus 2N makes total 4N. You can see the DNA has been doubled here. Next, what happens further? Then what happens? Then the cell enters to G2 phase. G2 phase. Right? And when the cell enters to G2 phase, what happens then? During G2 phase, the cell also a little bit grows inside. We know that. And after G2, what happens next? Look carefully, friends. Here, our DNA is, you can see here we have double DNA. Then after G2, what happens? The cell enters, look, G2 has been cleared. Then the cell enters to mitotic phase, the division phase. So after, when the cell exits the G2 phase, what happens? The cell divides. You can see here, the cell has been started division. Like this. You can see. Clear? So here we have one nucleus here and one nucleus here. And here we have one set of DNA in this cell, one set of DNA in this cell. So you can see here, we have started with a 2N DNA and we are ending with a 2N DNA in both cells, right? So from here, here the G2 phase completes, and here we see that this is our mitotic phase. Mitotic phase. Clear? So after mitotic phase, you can see here the nuclei have been separated from each other. Two nuclei are present, and here you can see there is a groove in the cell membrane. So here our cytokinesis starts, and cytokinesis completes, so we get a set of two cells. Clear? We got two cells from this one cell. In different events, in different steps and phases, right? So these events are called the interphase, right? And from here onward, this is called the M phase or mitotic phase. What happened here? The cell has been divided. So we will see these mitotic phases there in this lecture, in the next lecture, right? Let's see further. Let's one step more. If the cell wants to divide further, so this cell will enter again to which phase? To G1, right? The cell will enter to G1 phase again and will start the cycle again and will go on and on. And if there is a cell and this cell doesn't want to divide further, this cell will enter to G0 phase or G0 phase, or we simply call it G0 phase or growth not phase, right? So if the cell doesn't want to divide further, this cell will enter to G0 phase. And if the cell wants to keep on the division, keep on dividing, this cell will enter from mitotic phase, this cell will jump to G1 phase, and again the S phase, and again the G2 and mitotic phase, and the cycle will be going on. Clear? So this whole concept is related to cell cycle. Look carefully. From here, my dear friends, from here onward, like this, up to here, all these events which I have encircled right here, all these events combined as G1, S and G2, these are called the interphase. These are called interphase. And all the events from the end of the G2 phase up to the end of the cell division, up to the end of cytokinesis, all these events are called the mitotic phase. Clear? So there are two events. There are two events of the cell cycle. What are those? Those are the interphase and the mitotic phase. You can see here. Clear? So the cell, this cell will now, if this cell wants to divide further, this cell will enter to what? G1 phase, then towards S phase, then towards G2 phase, and then towards again mitotic phase. Mitotic phase, and this cell will again make two cells, and if they want further division, they will again jump to G1 phase, and then will carry the division further and forward. Right? So this was a very basic concept related to the cell cycle and cell division, my dear friends. Now, dear friends, we should know that who are the beginners of this G1 and who are the stoppers of the G1 phase, right? Who is going to tell the cell to enter the G1 phase and start the cycle, and who is telling the cell to stop the cycle and don't go to G1, we don't want to divide further, we are stopping our division here, right? So we know that whatever happens in our body, whatever happens in our body, all these are under the control of our genome, our DNA. So all these processes are stored in the DNA, and the genes which are present on the DNA and the proteins which are created by these genes, so all those proteins and genes are responsible to develop the concept to the cell that you are going to divide and you are not going to divide furthermore. So stop here and you please go to G1 and start the division again. Right, friends? So we will see those molecular processes which are occurring inside the cell, and those molecular processes are responsible, right? Those molecular processes are responsible to carry out the division further or to stop the division from going onward. Right? So see you in the next lecture regarding the molecular phases which are occurring in the G1, NS, and in the G2. Thank you so much.